Hi,
And
everybody. My name is Caroline Colas, and I am the Senior Director of Health and Wellness at the Marlene Meyerson JCC Manhattan. Today, on our Positivity Psychology Hour, a series that we run with the Whole Being Institute, we are going to be talking about wisdom from Groundhog Day and via character strengths with a dear friend and colleague, Jane Anderson. Is every day beginning to feel like Groundhog Day to you? That's the film where the days blur into one another, or you feel stuck, unmotivated, or bored. Today, February 2nd, is actually Groundhog Day, a day to change the conversation. So we're so glad that you're here to join us for a lighthearted, interactive look at the intersection of Groundhog Day and the character strengths, the 24 positive personality traits like teamwork and bravery that every one of us has, but just in a different constellation. When used deliberately, your character strengths can prepare you to navigate virtually any life challenge and shift into possibility, purpose, and potential. Jane Anderson, author of 30 Days of Character Strengths, will share her wisdom from the 1993 hit movie Groundhog Day and the two foundational strength practices you can apply immediately today in the middle of this snowstorm if you're in New York City in a personal or professional setting. To identify your unique profile of character strengths, of course, you can take the free survey at the VIA Strengths website, which Phoebe will put into the chat. I want to tell you a little bit about Jane. She is the president of Strength-Based Living, a business dedicated to helping individuals and groups harness character strengths from the field of positive psychology. The scientific study of human flourishing, character strengths are 24 personality traits like creativity, perseverance, honesty, bravery, that lead to living a life of substance, even in dark times. She's also the author, as I said, of 30 Days of Character Strengths, A Guided Practice to Ignite Your Best. This wonderful book, I actually own it. I highly recommend it. It offers a unique guided character strength journey spanning 30 days. So you can do it as like a 30-day practice and actually develop more of your character strengths or strengthen them. She has presented at global positive psychology conferences and served as a guest faculty for the Whole Being Institute, an educational organization, and supported world-renowned positive psychology experts in the classroom. Welcome to the call, Jane. So good to see you.
Wow, what a zesty introduction. I love that. Thank you so much. It's so good to be here. And before I put my slides up, I'd like to invite everybody to, can we have everybody put their view in gallery view?
Sure, I'll take us off, you off spot.
Yeah, and unmute all of the microphones. Normally we might start one of these with a mindfulness practice to get ourselves grounded, but I'd like to start with a practice, a short little intro that is going to boost our zest and our connection since we can't all be together. So I'd like to have everybody on gallery view where you can see all the pictures on the screen and you can scroll through the screens to see everyone's picture. And unmute your microphone. And we're just gonna do a simple greeting. And the way we'll do this is, you see all the little boxes of people to your right and your left and above and below you. We're gonna be sort of like on the Brady Bunch. We're gonna all together turn to the person on our right, greet them by name. So for me, it's Marsha. We're gonna go, hi, Marsha. And we're gonna say this all together. Fill the Zoom room with our voices in greeting with each other. So we'll go right, left, up, down. Make sure everybody's greeted. Make sense?
Okay.
Okay. So here we go. Turn to the person to your right and just say good morning. So good morning, Paul.
Good morning, Jane.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
And the person to your
morning,
left.
Good morning, girl. Good morning,
Caroline. Caroline.
Hello, Grace. Hi. Nice to see you. Yeah. And the person above you.
Good morning.
Hello,
good
morning. Lena.
Hi,
Shelly.
Oh,
nice to meet you this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And the person below you now.
Good morning,
and Sharon. Sharon.
Linda.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Judith.
And if there's anyone else you'd like to say hello to, just choose someone and randomly say hello, maybe to somebody.
Hi, Cheryl.
Hi, Ellen.
Hello,
Joanne.
Hi, Joanne.
Hi, Eva.
Hi, Donna.
Carrie.
Hi, Joanne.
Hi, Susan.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Hi, Josephine.
Wow.
So it's like a chorus of greetings today. Thank you for being part of our chorus this morning. Love that.
Love it.
Okay. Now we can all mute our microphones and we'll get started. I'll put my, I'll share my screen, get my slides up here. And thank you for that. I love that. That felt really good. Let's see here. There we go. So as Caroline mentioned, well, first I want to say I'm so happy to be with you today. It's been a long time since I've been with you, and it's wonderful to be back in these days. And as Caroline mentioned, today is Groundhog Day. And in Groundhog Day tradition, you may know this, but this is the day when the groundhog named Phil, he has a name, Punxsutawney Phil, in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania. He comes out of his habitat and he basically predicts whether there will be an early spring or six more weeks of winter. This morning he came out, as he does every year, you may know this or seen it in the news. He came out at about 7:30 a.m. Eastern time and saw his shadow, which means another 6 weeks of winter. Now, if you enjoy snow and cold, this is good news for you, right? So maybe you'll want to use your character strength of zest to keep that excitement going. If this isn't such great news for you, you're not really into winter, you're ready for, you know, the 15 inches of snow to be gone, maybe perseverance could help, you know, lifting perseverance could help us get through this, or maybe prudence, right? To not just be cautious, but to help us plan ways and creative ways of getting us through this time. So there are many intersections between character strengths and Groundhog Day. And who knew? I never knew this until I started looking into this for this presentation. But let me take a step back. Character strengths, as Caroline mentioned, are 24 positive personality traits, like the ones you see here on the screen. This is the classification of 24 character strengths. It's 24 strengths organized within virtue categories. So strengths that cultivate wisdom are listed here, that cultivate courage, that cultivate humanity. And these virtues are things that are valued in societies all around the world. When used deliberately, your character strengths can prepare you to navigate almost any life challenge. And not only that, but also lead you into new possibilities. So we need all 24 of these capacities in our toolbox right now. These are, in a sense, tools that we have access to that we can engage deliberately. So today I'm going to share some wisdom from the 1993 hit movie Groundhog Day. I'll give an overview of what character strengths are and why they matter. I know that some of you have already seen numerous presentations on character strengths, so we'll just go through this real quickly. And then I'll share two foundational strengths practices that you can apply. So before we launch into that, I have a couple of polls that I'd like to take to just gather a little bit of information. So nothing too taxing. Here is the first question, and this is just a yes or no. So have you taken the VIA Character Strengths Survey? This is an assessment that takes about 15 minutes to complete. It's a scientifically validated measurement of character strengths. And if you have taken it, that's great. You can work with your results. And if you haven't taken it, that's great too. You can choose character strength. I'll provide images of the 24 that you can choose from, or you can pick another strength. More flexible here. Okay, so it looks like about everybody's about done, so I'm going to end the polling. Oh, how interesting. And share the results. So Let's see. Can you see? Can you all see the results?
Yes, I can.
Great. Okay. So 50% have taken the survey and 50% have not. On the dot. How interesting is that? All right. Now I'd like to launch the next quick poll. I told you this wouldn't be too taxing. Let's end that one and go on to the next one. Okay, the movie. Have you seen the 1993 movie Groundhog Day? Have you seen the movie? Yes or no? If you have, great. You can help me describe what's happening in some of the scenes we're going to look at. And if you haven't, no worries. I'll give you a little bit of context and basically everything that you need to know about it in order to participate.
You're not seeing the poll, so hang on one second. I'm going to stop sharing for one second.
Okay.
And then let's just share. Let me just share results for one second.
Okay.
Stop sharing. Now let's go into the next poll. Try it one more time.
Okay. Let's see. Here we go. Launch the polling.
Yes.
Okay, how's that? Okay, good. So have you seen the movie, yes or no? So here we go. The results are coming in. It looks like many of you have seen the movie. Great. And it looks like we're about done. Awesome. I'm going to end the poll. So share the results. Can you see the results here?
Yes.
69% have seen the movie. Excellent. It's such a classic. I had never seen it before 2 weeks ago. Who knew? I've really enjoyed it. And I didn't even realize there were so many positive psychology-based lessons in this really cute movie. Okay, so I'm going to stop sharing and move on to the final poll. Okay. At any time during this pandemic, have you felt like every day is Groundhog Day? So in other words, this is where things seem the same. Yeah, the results are coming in overwhelmingly. The days seem the same. Wednesday seems like Sunday, and Sunday seems like, you know, Tuesday, and the days kind of just go into one another. Same conversations, same routines. Yeah, so it's looking about maybe 80% yes, have felt like it's Groundhog Day, and no, 21% no. Here, I'll share these results real quickly.
We can see them, they're great.
Yeah, so a lot of you have felt like every day is Groundhog Day. So for those of you who haven't, you can give us some tips and maybe what character strengths you're using such that that doesn't happen. And for the rest of us, we're going to work with that too. So great. Thank you for participating in these quick polls. Next, I'd like to give you a quick summary of the movie so that you have just a little bit of background information. Okay, so in a nutshell, this is a movie starring Bill Murray and Andy McDowell, as you can see on the screen. Bill Murray's character, his name is Phil, coincidentally, and Phil is a sarcastic weatherman, and what he's looking for basically in life is kind of what many of us are looking for, a meaningful relationship with someone special. But with Phil, his ego is constantly getting in the way, but he's not aware of this. He's not aware of how he's affecting other people. He travels to Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania to cover the Groundhog Day event where the groundhog comes out and sees his shadow or doesn't. And Andy McDowell, her character's name is Rita. She's the object of his affections. She's also the news producer, sweet, hardworking part of the team. She's covering this event, so she's in the background. And because of a big snowstorm on Groundhog Day, they end up staying in Punxsutawney, Philadelphia overnight before they can get out the next day. But what happens is every day he wakes up to face the same day. The same song playing on the clock radio, the same conversations, the same people, the same routine. Every day is Groundhog Day. Every day, every time he wakes up, it's Groundhog Day starting all over again. So for 79% of us, this sounds very familiar. He begins to notice this and the fact that then he can do whatever he wants to do and get away with it. So he stuffs his face with donuts. He drives his car on the railroad tracks, etc. He does this because he sees that there are no consequences of his actions. They're erased the next day. Ultimately, he realizes the path he's on and that his sarcastic, egotistical approach, it isn't really taking him where he wants to go. So he begins to learn day by day that he can achieve different results if he changes his actions, his thoughts, his beliefs. He can see different results if he changes. Okay. So what I see through the lens of character strengths is that by living into his strengths and using them for good in the world around him, he ultimately gets what he wants and is set free from this prison he's in every day being Groundhog Day. So if you haven't seen it, I don't want to give too much away. If it's been a while, you know, today's Groundhog Day. It's streamed on, I think it's Netflix or somewhere. You can Google it and find out. Okay, so that's a quick summary of the movie. I think I'm going to move on here. Back to character strengths. Okay, so we're going to just go back and forth a little bit in the beginning here until we bring them together. So you have many different kinds of strengths. We all do, right? We have physical strengths, so the things that help us build strong bodies, build our muscles. We have talents and skills, which are the things that we can practice and develop proficiency in, like playing an instrument or sports or debating. We have interests, which is what we're passionate about. And then we have character strengths. Character strengths are the type of strengths that they represent the essence of who you are. So maybe they're part of your positive personality. So maybe you're sort of naturally lighthearted and fun, or maybe you're naturally more serious and love to learn and study things. Maybe perhaps you're naturally good working on a team or getting stuff done. So these are all examples of character strengths: humor, love of learning, teamwork, perseverance, 24 in all. Now, we tend to know all the things we're not strong in, right? We're not patient enough. We don't listen often enough. We don't, we need to improve on one thing or another. And it's true. We do need patience. Listening is a good skill to have. We need these. We need these skills to navigate successfully in life. But what about all the things that we're good, that we're strong in, the things that are right about us, that's good about us, the bravery, the kindness, the honesty? Where's the honesty, right? We tend not to focus on these as much in terms of developing them and prioritizing them in our children, our teams, our organizations, our government, right? That's all I'll say about that right now. So today we're going to focus on what's right with us, our character strengths. And just to kind of wrap up this little blurb on character strengths, I'm going to show you just 2 minutes of a short video that introduces the science behind this groundbreaking framework. So here we go.
There are 7 billion, well actually 7.1 billion humans on the planet. And each one of us has a unique character.
So what determines your character?
You do.
And all the people around you.
And of course some genetics too.
But there's new science proving that if you focus on certain parts of who you are, you can develop your character
and ultimately live a more meaningful, successful, and happy life, no matter what your circumstances. I mean, isn't that what we're all trying to figure out?
Oh, what?
This whole idea about developing our character really took shape in 2004, when two psychologists suggested that instead of just focusing on all the things that can go wrong with us, it's also important to celebrate all the things that can go right. You see, they looked throughout history to identify core virtues that humans across cultures have agreed lead to a meaningful life. And then they identified 24 character strengths that, when practiced and developed, could lead to these virtues. And they organized them, like scientists have done throughout history to understand things better. These groundbreaking studies showed that every person is a unique combination of these strengths. Like for me, I'm high on curiosity. I could work a little on the prudence. Actually, what is prudence? Anyhow, one of the most interesting parts of all this is they found that if we focus on building upon the strengths we have, it has a lasting effect on our happiness and well-being. So think about it. What are your top five strengths? Now, another part of this is that you can help shape other people's character too. They found that the key to human relationships is ultimately appreciating the character strengths in others.
Okay, so let's stop this right there. And just to recap a few of the key points, and then I'm gonna take my slides down and see if there are any questions here. So a few key points. Instead of looking at all of the things that go wrong with us all the time, we can also celebrate and embrace the things that are right with us, our character strengths. You have your own unique mix of character strengths. We each do. And in fact, the odds of anyone else having the exact same profile that you have are 1 in 600 sextillion. That's how unique and special each of us is. One of the keys is to learn to tap into these and use them deliberately to benefit ourselves and other people. And another key is to strengthen relationships by noticing and valuing the strengths in others. It was noted just at the end of this clip that appreciating and valuing the strengths of other people is key to positive relationships. So with that, I'm going to stop my share for a minute and see if we have any questions. Is there anything in the chat that we need to look at here?
Yeah, we had someone, I think it was Kathy tried to sign up on character on strength-based living. Would you mean for the VIA character strengths survey, Kathy? If you want to take that. Yeah.
I don't know, I think it was like to get on the mailing list or something for, I don't know, I can go back out and look.
No, you know what, I have to apologize for this. I'm doing a website refresh and my whole website is being upgraded. And unfortunately there are occasionally some glitches on the old website as they're developing the new one. So if you'd like, I will just offer this right now. Just email me, jane@strengthbasedliving, strength one, strength, not numerous, strengthbasedliving.com. Uh-huh. And let me know that you'd like to be added to the to my blog list, or if you'd like to take the survey and you're struggling to do it, whatever it is that you'd like, just feel free to contact me.
Thank you.
You're great. Welcome.
And I also thought you would find it interesting, Jane, the question you asked for those that weren't experiencing Groundhog Day, what strengths were they using? And Pamela said, love of learning helps me keep every day fresh. Anne said, scheduling activities each day, something different. Kelly said, using top strengths of appreciation of beauty and excellence and gratitude. Yeah, strengths of gratitude, appreciation, resilience, and curiosity. So I just thought that was interesting.
Yeah, so we're interesting how we're also using different strengths, right? We all have different go-to strengths. So Caroline and I were speaking at the very beginning that we're both very high in creativity. So those are our go-to strengths because they're just part of our personality. It's a natural part. That's, we like to problem solve. We like to brainstorm. We like to create things. You know, we could be doing this all the time, which is great sometimes, but not all the time, right? We need other strengths too. We need every strength and we need everyone's strengths, top strengths especially. Yeah, thank you. Are there any other questions that anyone would like to ask? If so, just put it in the chat and we'll cover that. And if not, then I'll go on because I want to get to the practices for today. That's where it gets really fun, where we can have some interaction. Anything going on?
No, I think we're good. I think everybody's good. Kathy said, I'm an introvert, so I'm used to spending my days alone. And several other people said, one of the ways they're making the days less the same, kindness and honesty, curiosity and working, love of learning and perseverance and gratitude.
Beautiful. So those of us that are struggling more can take some lessons from you and maybe look into our own strengths to see, you know, if you're happy being spending more time alone. Love that. I love hearing about the strengths that you're using and just continue using that, using those strengths and trying out some new strengths maybe too. We'll talk about experimenting a little bit later in the next half hour. And if you're struggling right now, I'd offer the same tip as we'll think about which strengths can help you. And actually that's a good segue into moving forward because we're actually going to do an activity, think of an example of what we're challenged by in these times. And for you, perhaps it would be feeling lonely and which character strengths can help. So we'll just put that on the back burner for a second and I'll go ahead and share my screen again. Okay, so let's move these forward. Here are the 24. I don't want to spend too much time here because I'll keep this up. I know you've seen these before, many of them you're familiar with. So I think I'll just highlight a few that might pop out for you. I know judgment is one that a lot of people will ask about and they'll say, oh, you know, isn't this about being judgmental? No, judgment is about critical thinking. So when it's used in a balanced sense, it's a very positive strength that we need when we're making decisions and so on. The overuse of judgment, yes, can lean into being judgmental. And each of the 24 strengths can be overused or underused. And when we are shifting into that over or underuse, these strengths aren't really acting like strengths anymore, right? So when we talk about these being strengths, we're really talking about a balanced use of these strengths, not too much or too little for the situation. So I just mentioned that. And then also let's run down to spirituality. Spirituality is about seeking the sacred, seeking what's sacred. And so, you know, things that are blessed, reverent, that you revere, could be a walk in nature. It could be religion, but it doesn't have to be. This is where we find meaning in our lives can find meaning through spirituality. And mentioned zest, I think that's pretty self-explanatory. Yeah, so I'll keep this up. We're gonna come back to this list when we get to the activity in just a minute. Okay, we're going to talk about the first foundational practice. And in order to do any of this work with character strengths, we need to first notice them in action. We need to notice them in ourselves. We need to notice them in others, our friends, our children, our parents, our coworkers. And this practice is called strength spotting. Why is strength spotting so foundational? Well, a few reasons. Number one, it helps us to build strong relationships. It connects us. And you heard in the video that it is key to strong relationships. It helps us feel, number two, it helps us feel more confident, less anxious. When we're noticing our own strengths and using them deliberately, We feel stronger, we feel more authentic and real. And finally, we feel valued. When someone sees you for your strengths, it feels so good. It's like a gift that we can give. We feel.
Oh, we lost you there for a moment, Jane.
We are valued for our strengths. We feel understood. We feel seen. We feel energized. And so this is the gift that we can give all the time, and we can do this more often and really need to on teams, with partners, and wherever we go, basically. Now, the VIA Institute on Character, which is kind of all things character strengths, they suggest a model for strength spotting that you see down here, the C approach. The S stands for see the strength. In other words, you know, notice it, name it, identify it. The E stands for explain, which means giving a little bit of detail or context around when you saw the strength in action. And then the A, appreciating it, openly acknowledging it and saying, oh, you know, thank you for, you know, here's why I valued seeing this strength in you. And so what we're going to do next is practice strength spotting. We're going to do this together in a minute, but so I have this little clip of, this is from the movie Groundhog Day. So it's a scene from Groundhog Day. And let me just give you a little intro to the scene. Bill Murray is trying some new approaches to his limited relationship with Rita. He's trying to do things a little bit differently in approaching her. And she's skeptical because of the way he has treated her and other people in the past. And she's kind of responding with, you know, she's a little snarky. She's a little sarcastic, but you see her softening a little bit. So as you're watching, just go ahead and write down. You can use the chat if you like. That would be great, actually. Name the strengths that you see in either of the characters. And if you're a little bit more comfortable strength spotting, maybe start looking for overuse of strengths or underuse of any of the strengths in either character. So you can go ahead and start putting those in the chat as you see them, or you can wait until afterwards. So here we go. Whoops, here we don't go.
Rita, if you only had one day to live, what would you do with it?
I don't know, Phil. What are you dying of?
No, I mean, the whole world is about to explode. What do you do?
I just want to know where to put the camera. What are you looking for, Phil? A date for the weekend?
No, I'm just interested in you. You know, what do you... What do you think about? What kind of men are you interested in? What do you do for fun?
Is this for real, Phil? Or are you just trying to...
I'm sorry.
I'm just trying to talk like normal people talk. Isn't this how they talk?
Plus.
Okay, so talk to me. Let me buy you a cup of coffee. And a donut.
All right.
So what do you want out of life anyway?
I guess I want what everybody wants, you know. Career, love, marriage, children.
Are you seeing anyone?
I think this is getting too personal. I don't think I'm ready to share this with you. How about you? What do you want?
What I really want is someone like you.
Oh, please.
Well, why not? What are you looking for? Who is your perfect guy?
Well, first of all, he's too humble to know he's perfect.
That's me.
He's intelligent, supportive, funny.
Intelligent, supportive, funny. Me, me, me.
He's romantic and courageous.
Me also.
He's got a good body, but he doesn't have to look in the mirror every 2 minutes.
I have a great body, and sometimes I go months without looking.
He's kind, sensitive, and gentle. He's not afraid to cry in front of me.
This is a man we're talking about, right?
He likes animals, children and he'll change poopy diapers.
Does he have to use the word poopy?
Oh, and he plays an instrument and he loves his mother.
I am really close on this one. Really, really close.
Oh boy. Does he change poopy diapers? All right, so let's go to the chat here and see what we've got going. I know there are a lot of entries, so I know that you're putting a lot of strength in here.
Lots of humor, curiosity, kindness, perseverance. Let's see, we've got humor, generosity, Phil offering to buy coffee and donuts, critical mm-hmm. thinking, curiosity, where is that humility? Lots of love. Curiosity, kindness, Addie's character, withholding, sarcastic, superficial. Colette, genuine, honest, curiosity, caring, humor. Phil has humor. Muriel, kindness, honesty, humor. Curiosity, mirroring strengths, humor. Perseverance, unknowingly. Creativity, curiosity, generosity, humor. Lots of humor, curiosity, lots of that, yeah.
Yeah. Wonderful job. Wonderful. I hear some, a wide range of the character strengths, but also some examples of over and under use. Now, if we had more time, I would have some of you come up on camera and share a little bit more with me and give some examples. So when did you see curiosity or honesty? When did so-and-so appear over interested? And what kind of impact does this have on the situation, on the conversation, on the other person? We can begin to see in real life how this over and under use can actually bring some negative consequences. It really causes some conflict and frustration, especially in relationships, as you could see here. But, you know, you got to give it to Phil. I mean, he really, in the context of this whole movie, he seems a little sarcastic now, but he's actually growing. He's stretching in this scene. He's trying something new. He's being curious and being interested in her and the other character strengths, as you mentioned. So job well done. Very proud of all of you. And I'll share my screen again. Okay. So how do we begin? If we want to do more of this in our lives, how do we start? Well, my suggestion is that you add strength spotting to what you're already doing. So what is that? Well, if you're attending meetings, you can bring strength spotting into the meeting. I like to do it at the beginning of a meeting because it sets a nice positive tone. But talking about, you know, what's gone well, what are our accomplishments, and who contributed what strengths to these accomplishments, and just making sure everyone gets strength spotted. Do it at the beginning, do it at the end. As I said, I like to do it at the beginning. You're sending emails every day, right? When you send an email to a friend or a colleague, think of an example of when they were at their best and what strength did you notice in them? I really appreciated your bravery when you stood up to the boss the other day. Here's, you know, how that impacted me. Or thank you so much for your kindness in helping me with my groceries. But I really appreciated that. It was a hard time, etc. Family rituals around the dinner table or breakfast table or at bedtime. Just taking a moment to, instead of the usual, you know, how was your day, honey? It was, you know, there was too much snow and I was cold and so on, the litany of complaints. What went well? What strengths did you use? What was one strength that you really noticed today in your life? And each, you know, going around and sharing. Favorite book characters or movie characters, like we just did, watching a movie that's inspiring and pointing out the character strengths that they're using to move them through the challenge and through the action. when you're just out on the street, there are kindnesses that are happening all the time. There are people showing love all the time. There are people being prudent and creative. And so just noticing it, and maybe even, you know, if it feels right, to approach the person and share your thoughts with them. It's sometimes, you know, I've done this. Sometimes, you know, it's well received, and sometimes people, you know, come up and or they just are so surprised that they're not used to having this happen, and it's a little bit abrupt. But when I do it, I always feel good. And I think even if we don't know what the impacts are in the moment, I can assure you it will be a memorable moment. So also when things are going well, and also when things are not going well, when you're challenged, when every day feels like Groundhog Day, when the person in your life who really bugs you is really bugging you, they still have character strengths. And so often naming them, noticing them can help us shift ourselves, our conversations and relationships. In fact, workshop participants tell me that this is one of the most impactful things in their lives, that when they start looking at difficult people in their lives, their relationships, through a lens of strengths, their relationships begin to shift. Okay, so that was the first foundational practice, strength spotting. The second one is leaning into your signature strengths and using them in new ways. This is not as easy because we're noticing our own character strengths. It seems pretty intuitive to many of us to notice strengths in others, but when it comes to noticing our own strengths, it can be a little bit more awkward or difficult. Now, as I mentioned, you have your own top strengths. These are called your signature strengths. And if you've taken the survey, if you look at your top, you know, signature strengths are usually the top 5 to 7. And if you haven't taken the survey, you can. Here's a URL where you can go to take it, tinyurl.com/your-character-strengths. But we know that we're using a signature strength when we feel like we're in the zone, when we feel energized. Signature strengths are essential, so we feel really authentic and acting in integrity, the real you. We feel unstoppable with a high level of performance. So there are lots of reasons for using these signature strengths, and this is well researched, that the use of a signature strength in a new way every day for a week can reduce depression and anxiety for months. So this is a very important and impactful strengths practice. And I'd like to now focus on one of your strengths practices. If we have some questions, we can take a few questions before we go into this, but we're going to go into breakout rooms. I'm calling them tune-in rooms, where we're going to tune into each other and our signature strengths. Before we do this, I'd like to give you each about a minute. I'm going to go silent for about a minute. And during this minute, think of an example of when you were at your best and one strength that resonates as signature. Now I'm going to advance to this slide so that you have the list of character strengths to choose from if you want to choose a signature character strength. Which one of these feels like a signature strength to you, resonates? And when you think of an example of you at your best, this is not an epic, you know, a lot of people get stuck on that. Well, I don't feel like I've ever been my best, or the best is yet to come. No, we've all had best moments of connection. It could be a moment of connection. It could be you've accomplished a meaningful goal. It could be you've had a successful relationship. It could be recent or past, anytime. Okay. So I'm going to, while you're doing that, well, I'm going to give you a minute. And while you're doing that, I'm going to look in the chat, see what we've got. So go ahead. Okay, so wrapping up, and just before we go into the tune-in rooms, we'll put about four of you in a room, and then I'll give you the instructions in just a minute. But just to connect around a few of the questions, Muriel does strength spotting in stores. That's awesome. Elaine grew up in a home that gave the message that self-praise wasn't a positive thing. That's right. I learned that too, that you just didn't talk about yourself in that way. So that was really hard for me. I still have those tapes sort of playing in my head. I have to work at this, the strength work sometimes. Yes, see the research on anxiety and depression on the VIA website under their research tab, and it's organized by topic. So if you go into the section on signature strengths, you will see all sorts of findings, but also the one about depression and anxiety. What else do we have here? The URL doesn't work. It takes you to a different website. It should take you to a page that allows you to start the survey. So if that's not what's happening, Linda, just send me an email, jane@strengthbasedliving.com.
Jane, we also put in the VIA Character Strengths link as well, so they can go to that.
Okay, great. Yep.
And Bunny asked a great question. I believe I have more of the favorable strengths and some of the negative traits for sure. Don't we all have some imperfections?
Well, I think we all have imperfections. Yeah, none of us is perfect, and we don't need or really want to be perfect, I don't think. I think that would be kind of boring, actually. but in terms of character strengths, as I mentioned before, we all have all 24 of the strengths. So when you take the survey, you get a ranked list from number one through number 24, and those lower strengths are considered lower strengths, not weaknesses. There's still strengths that we all have. So for instance, self-regulation and prudence, for example, tend to be lower in the general population, not for everybody. Some people have signature strengths that are self-regulation or prudence, but in the general population, that's what they find. And so it's not that that includes me, it's not that we don't have those strengths, it's that it takes a little bit more for us to raise those. And we're not as natural as the top strengths that we have on our list, right? So we still have them. I wouldn't call them imperfections. In strengths language, it's considered lower strengths, middle strengths, and signature strengths. And the overuse and the underuse can start to branch out into these sort of different domains where we're talking about, some people call them weaknesses. They start to act like weaknesses. They're not really acting like strengths. When you overuse curiosity, for instance, it can be intrusive when you're too interested or asking too many personal questions, right? It can push people away. So, but at that point, it's not really acting like a strength anymore. I hope that addresses the point or the question.
I think that's a very interesting way to look at it, Jane. And I was just wondering, in other words, instead of it being, yes, we're all human and therefore we're not even designed to be perfect, but to look at, oh gosh, if I'm overusing a strength, that may actually be, it becomes a weakness. Or something that makes me, not able to show up in positive psychology language in the way that I'm at my best.
That's a great point, Caroline. And the interesting thing, the positive thing about this is now it gives us a framework for problem solving, right? So if we are aware that we're overusing curiosity, for instance, we can do something about that. We can pull that back. We can temper that overuse and maybe, elevate one that's more appropriate for the moment. Maybe it's more appropriate to use social intelligence and just listen, try to understand what the other person is saying or where they're coming from. Or maybe it's more appropriate to use perspective, just looking at the big picture. It all depends on the situation,
sure.
Which is part of the challenge and the fun. It depends on the situation and what's happening and who you're with.
And what I love about it is it just doesn't label you as good at this or bad at that, or having a not being capable of something and then not being capable of something else. You know what I mean? Sometimes we go good or bad with our human behavior, and this takes it out of a different and puts it in a different context altogether. I wanted to just ask you to make me the host because I think you want me to put people into breakout rooms.
Yes, I do. So let me find you.
Do that.
There you are.
Okay. And I'll make you,
you the host. There we go. Thank you, Caroline.
Mm-hmm. All right. And should I do that now?
Let me explain this first. Let's see, how are we doing on time? Oh gosh, okay, so we've only got 7 minutes left. I think we're gonna, in the interest of ending on time, I think we're going to have to bypass the breakout rooms, the tune-in rooms, and instead we'll go right to an activity that was intended to be a follow-up activity, but we'll just modify it a little bit. If that's okay. I want to honor everyone's time, and honesty is one of my signature strengths, and so integrity is part of that. And when we say these are going to be an hour, it's important for me to end in an hour. So that's what we're going to try to do. So I apologize for that, but honestly, the conversation has been so great, and your participation has been so insightful. So. I think it's nice to be able to just go with that. Okay. So here is an activity that we can do right now. And I'm going to modify this just a little bit. I'll give you a little bit of time, but then I would like to ask for a volunteer to come on camera, to be brave, offer some teamwork in being together with me on screen, on camera, and talk about their example. So think about if you could be a little bit brave and work on teamwork and also leadership. So I'm going to give you a minute to think of a challenge you'll face today or tomorrow or soon. It doesn't have to be exactly today or tomorrow. And choose one character strength, probably a signature strength, and identify one way you will use that strength to address this challenge that you'll be facing today or tomorrow. So think of one way you can use a signature strength. And then as we leave here, I'm going to invite you to put that into action. So I'll give you about another minute or so. Okay, so our time is about up for the thinking and reflecting, and now comes the moment of truth. I'm going to take down the slides, and who would like to join me and share their example and talk about the strengths? You can raise your hand, you can post in the chat. Caroline, maybe you can help me see who's willing to share.
I'll
thinking. I don't see any hands raised. You can also unmute. Oh, Wendy has her hand raised.
Wonderful. Wendy. I have to
I've never
where
met
you
a
are.
One I didn't like, Jane, so I'll always jump in.
Wonderful. Is one of your top strengths leadership?
It's not, actually. It's not. Yeah.
Bravery. Well, thank you for sharing. Yeah. I appreciate it. So would you give us a short example that you're finding a challenge as coming up?
Yeah. Right now I'm in the midst of dealing with my sister, who is in the middle of a mental health crisis right now. And it's very challenging. And I'm going to be going over tomorrow and to visit. And I have to be very, a lot of being needs to happen now, not a lot of doing. And I'm a doer, right? So I want to move things forward, but this is not the time to do that. Yeah. So what I believe, there's a couple of strengths that I think could show up in this.
Mm-hmm. Could you name one, Wendy? What would be your top strength and how might you use it to help you navigate this?
Well, my top strength is appreciation of beauty and excellence. Mm-hmm. And so I believe being with my sister where she is and putting my attention on the good part, like what I know is good with my sister and what we've enjoyed, and like that going into the house with that perspective is going to help me then come from a place of kindness and love, which are also in my top five, to be able to just be with her. Mm-hmm. And be with her.
Yeah, that's beautiful, Wendy. I like how you've noticed like one strength that can help you cascade into others as well. And I wonder, is there something that you could do, since you mentioned appreciation of beauty and excellence, is there one thing that you could do to cultivate that while you're there? Could you do something together that's cultivating beauty? Or could you look at pictures that are inspiring together? Or I'm just brainstorming here because that's what I do. And
Yes. Oh, I love what someone just said, that I will be strength spotting. So that's beautiful to be able to strength spot with my sister. I love that.
Yeah.
And, photos, she's not engaging. Do you know what I mean? She's dealing mm-hmm. with a lot of emptiness right now.
Yeah.
So she feels guilt when I want her to engage and she can't.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, so maybe trying a little bit of strength spotting and seeing how that goes. And that could actually be an activity of appreciating beauty and excellence, because you're appreciating her for what's beautiful in her. And so it could be, like you mentioned, it could be something that helps to cascade into other strengths. Thank you for sharing that, Wendy. That's so helpful. I wish you well and good luck trying it out as you go to visit, and best to your sister.
I love your book, babe. Love your book. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Wendy. Thank you so much. Okay, so I'm afraid that we are out of time. I just have one more quick slide to show you just to end our time together. And my final thought is, may you be fueled by your strengths as you rise to meet challenges and opportunities, both today and every day. So I'm happy to send the slides to you and send some resources. We can go through the chat and see if there are any unanswered questions and get to those. Please feel free to contact me. As I mentioned, here's my email address. And I've so enjoyed being with you today. Thank you to Caroline and Phoebe and to all of you who are out there doing the good work in this world. So thank you.
Thank you so much, Jane. I just wanted to remind everybody that on Thursday, Mega and myself will be looking at positivity and the heart. Tonight, we have Jim McNerney, who will be talking about releasing yourself from the stress of pandemic eating. And then this weekend, we have two amazing programs. Robin Mandel is going to teach how to do a digital vision board. And Amy Kemi and Whitney Chapman will be doing, Amy plays the harp. She's going to play that live while Whitney teaches a gentle restorative yoga class. So lots of ways to increase your self-care and connect with your heart. So thank you so much, everybody, for coming. And I so appreciate Jane. Good to see you once again.
Good to see you too, everybody. And especially you, Caroline. Great to catch up.
And what time is Whitney? Let me just look at that. That's a great question. And we'll just go ahead. I'm going to unshare the screen, Jane, so we can see everybody and say goodbye. Unmute. And you can say,
thank you, Jane.
Bye.
Great seeing you again.
Thank you, Jane.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Caroline.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Enjoy the song again.
Thank you.
Take care, everybody.
Bye. Take care, everybody.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jane.